So basically, in a solid-state battery, we have replaced that volatile and flammable liquid and gel polymer electrolyte.
Honda has entered the market for solid-state batteries, consistently asserting that the current battery technology is not a viable long-term option. Lithium-ion batteries have drawn criticism for a number of factors, including their weight, reliance on rare earth elements, quick decomposition, and environmental impact. To address these difficulties, Honda is relying on solid-state batteries. Honda's Vice President of Business and Sales, Dave Gardner, recently spoke with TheDrive and highlighted his company's belief that lithium-ion technology will not be sufficient to meet all demands in the future. Honda's research of solid-state batteries holds the potential of smaller, lighter, and less resource-intensive batteries that nonetheless offer increased energy density, quick charging, and longer lifespan. Honda made an enormous $310 million investment on a cutting-edge solid-state battery production line for the purpose of advancing this project. This line is dedicated to evaluating the technology and the manufacturing method. But Toyota recently disclosed a development that might result in solid-state batteries with a staggering 745 miles of range on a single charge, with plans to increase that range to an amazing 900 miles. The invention of solid-state batteries is crucial to this evolution. The strategy Honda will use to beat Toyota at its own game. The fact that every automaker is vying for the newest, most powerful EV technology comes as no surprise, of course. But it has been widely reported in recent years that Toyota is putting a lot of effort into solid-state batteries for upcoming models as well as longer ranges for its cars, which may help it from the perspective of consumers. Toyota is investing heavily in solid-state batteries, but Honda, another dominant player in the market, has observed this and is working to outdo them. Honda specifically disclosed an expenditure of $310 million in a state-of-the-art solid-state battery production line intended for testing the technology and its manufacturing procedure. Future Honda electric cars will start to have these kinds of battery packs as a result of the establishment of this new solid-state testing facility. Furthermore, it's important to note that Honda, in contrast to Toyota, publicly, has developed a method of fending off dendrites, one of the biggest threats to solid-state batteries. On solid-state batteries, dendrites essentially grow after repeated usage and charging, causing them to deteriorate more quickly than we'd like. Dendrites can be disastrous for the lifespan and safety of solid-state batteries because these batteries' core parts are solid, not liquid. However, by changing the design, Honda came up with the concept of sandwiching polymer fabric between the electrolyte and the positive and negative electrodes, thus preventing the growth of dendrites. We're impressed with the Japanese automaker right now, and that's just one of the original concepts the company has brought to this still emerging EV technology. Honda, although arriving late to the party, might end up altering the game. Even though Honda has come under fire for its poor EV development and marketing, there may have been excellent reason for the firm to remain silent. However, Honda's recent expenditures in solid-state batteries and facilities to produce new super-powerful EVs suggest that they could be on the verge of a record-breaking achievement. On the other hand, Toyota has undoubtedly been a dominant force in the hybrid market for many years. Thanks to the renowned Prius, eco-friendly driving has become increasingly common and accessible. Honda needs to get ahead of Toyota's goal of having a roughly 900-mile range and a 10-minute charge time because it may change consumer expectations. There is fierce competition on all sides of the issue as a result of the widespread switch from fuel to electricity. Honda isn't seen as a dominant player in the electric vehicle market, whereas Toyota has made notable strides in both its technology and sales over the previous 5 years. By developing solid-state batteries, Honda is changing the public's perception and perhaps even luring potential partners from the auto sector. It's also extremely intriguing to note that Honda has remained independent, while Toyota has collaborated with a variety of battery manufacturers on its solid-state research. Honda argues that their research is self-funded and self-done, which could be advantageous, according to a news statement from the firm. Within the solid-state market, Honda may be a hidden powerhouse. It's interesting that after reading through Honda's various press releases and nuggets about solid-state batteries, we instantly notice the manufacturer's obvious intention to produce these battery packs on a large scale. Honda is aiming for something far more than a brand new EV fleet, because this has never been done before. Rather, it wants to transform the way they are produced in a methodical way. Given their lack of enthusiasm for the idea, you'd think Tesla would be leading the way in solid-state battery development. However, Honda has opted to take the lead. Toyota is attempting the same thing, but it hasn't been as eager in its intentions to bring these batteries to market on a large, worldwide scale. That doesn't mean they won't try, though, or that they can't. Because of this, we're confident that Honda and Toyota representatives closely monitor what each other says in press releases or other public or private statements. Toyota's solid-state battery deployment in 2027 is in the company's plans, so it seems that Honda has a similar release date in mind. However, even if there aren't many cars that take this into account, some brands, like Toyota and Honda, would want to work together to make a big impression. Honda's efforts to distribute these batteries on a broad scale before the end of the decade may suffer as a result of Toyota's alliance with battery manufacturer Panasonic. Likewise, a Toyota news release claims that the business has been developing solid-state technology since 2012 and has submitted 1,000 patent applications for solid-state batteries. Honda might include solid-state batteries in its vehicles by 2030. One thing to keep in mind is that Honda is actively planning a solid-state fleet of super EVs. The company is not just blowing smoke in our faces. According to reports, the corporation wants to deliver these cars to clients by the end of the 2020s, which would fundamentally alter the market for electric vehicles and manufacturing. Honda has continued its goal and responded fast to adversity despite obstacles encountered while developing and perfecting this battery technology. Honda would like for these automobiles to be on the roads by the second half of this decade, 2025 to 2030. In all likelihood, they would start selling these in North America and Asia before sending them to any other market that would be open to doing so. An enormous return on investment is what a brand wants when it goes all in. It will be fascinating to watch quarterly production and revenue numbers in 2025, because this is true for Honda, Toyota, or anyone else converting to solid-state technology. In order to compete with Toyota's seemingly limitless portfolio of patents, Honda may find it advantageous to develop a proprietary process for building its solid-state battery packs. However, who knows? It could all be strategic. The company hasn't been extremely patent-heavy so far. Meanwhile, the Acura ZDX is back. Early in 2019, the moniker makes a comeback to the lineup, this time paired with the automaker's first fully electric car and its most potent SUV ever. The 500-horsepower ZDX Type S and the Acura ZDX A-Spec are now available for purchase. The Honda Prologue and GM's Ultium battery and electrification technology platform were used in the co-development of the all-electric ZDX and Prologue, respectively. The ZDX A-Spec comes equipped with a 340-horsepower electric motor on its back axle as standard equipment at launch. The A-Spec should be able to go 325 miles between charges, thanks to its 102 kWh Ultium battery pack. Likewise, a dual-motor version is available, which promises better traction, but has a shorter range of 315 miles. Acura also states that the ZDX has a maximum towing capacity of 3,500 pounds, however doing so will probably reduce range. A fixed coil suspension, reactive dampers, and 20-inch wheels with 265/50R20 all-season tires support the SUV's weight. The ZDX's 12.6-inch front brakes are smaller than the typical 13.5-inch rear brakes. This intriguing backwards design was probably made possible by the EV's powerful regenerative braking ability. With significantly more powerful e-motors and the addition of sportier drive mode software, the high-performance ZDX Type S model has the same battery as the A-Spec. With a system total estimated at 500 horsepower and dual-motor all-wheel drive as a standard, this trim is the most potent SUV Acura has ever produced. And so, what are your thoughts on this episode? Let us know in the comment section below. If you've watched up to this point, thank you so much. For more videos about EVs, Toyota, Tesla, Ford, and the most recent auto news, please consider subscribing to Tech Addicts.